بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته and welcome back to the countdown just before the month of Ramadan. Today's reminder is that the month of Ramadan is indeed a wonderful opportunity for us to seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's nearness through giving. Month of Ramadan is indeed the month of giving. We know in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is mentioned regarding his generosity that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the most generous of all of mankind. Of all the people, he was the most generous. كان أجود الناس وأجود ما يكون في رمضان. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's generosity was more. It was seen more. It was witnessed more. He was more generous in the month of Ramadan than he was in any other month. And so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, every time he would be met by Jibril alayhi salam during the month of Ramadan, that's when he was most generous. And he was the analogy, the parable, the example of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's generosity is like that of a fast wind. So while we are fasting during the month of Ramadan, we should also try to spend as much as possible. We should try to give for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's sake. There are two angels that Allah has deputed every single morning to come out and to make dua. For the one who spends, Allahumma a'ti munfiqan khalafa. Oh Allah, the one who spends, give him compensation and give him something in return for that which he has spent. And oh Allah, the one who has held back, oh Allah, destroy his wealth. Allahumma a'ti mumsikan talafa, destruction. Let there be destruction for the one who is holding on to his or her wealth. So the month of Ramadan is the month of charity, the month of giving, the month of generosity. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is reported to have said, "As-sadaqatu tutfi'u al-khati'a kama yutfi'u al-ma'u an-nar." That charity, it extinguishes bad deeds, evil deeds, sins, just like water extinguishes fire. These are examples. In another hadith, the Prophet ﷺ is reported to have said, "Sadaqatu sir tutfi'u ghadab ar-rab," that giving sadaqa secretly, with ikhlas, with sincerity, this cools the anger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in another hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, he's reported to have said, "Kullu mri'in fi dhilli sadaqatihi yawm al-qiyamah," that everyone will be under the shade of his sadaqa on the day of Qiyamah. So sadaqah will be able to provide shade for those who obviously spent in this world, those who gave in charity. They will have a special shade under which they will take shade on the day of Qiyamah. Hina yuqla bayna nas. The Prophet ﷺ said, while people are being taken into account, while they are busy giving account of everything they've done in this world on the day of Qiyamah, this person will be resting under the shade of his charity, of his sadaqah. So the month of Ramadan is again, the month of sadaqah. Now, it doesn't mean we need so much in order to be able to give something. The hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, again, these are authentic, reliable hadith, the references for which, of course, are with us. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whether it's sharbati ma'in, aw madhqati labanin, aw tamratin, whether it's a sip of water or a sip of milk or just a little date that one gives, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give the giver the reward of the fasting person's fast. So not only does the one who fasted get the reward for his fast, but the one who gives him anything with which he breaks his or her fast, Allah will give the giver the reward of the fasting person's fast as well. Allahu Akbar. لا ينقص ذلك من أجورهم شيئا. And this won't diminish anything, any reward. There'll be no deficiency or no decrease in the reward. So this is why May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to prepare from now mentally and, you know, give. Make it a habit of giving. So when the month of Ramadan comes and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is multiplying our good deeds, we're able to give even more. And for those of us who have invested in this time into whatever you've invested in, remember, those are investments of this world. The true investments are the investments of the life hereafter. Allahumma la aisha illa aishul akhirah. The true life is the life hereafter. And the Prophet also said, Allahumma innahu la khayra illa khayrul akhirah. There's no goodness but the goodness of the life hereafter. Faghfir or farham lil ansari wal muhajirin. Nevertheless, stay tuned. We continue tomorrow. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.